This video is brought to you by Audible.
Welcome to this ASMR session with Alex. Chocolate. Oui.
Okay, stop.
Hey guys, salut, this is Alex. So today I want to make my own chocolate bar. They look beautiful, they look very graphical, and also they make great gifts.
They look graphical?
I'm definitely weird.
Of course, making my own chocolate bar should be pretty easy. This is baking chocolate, basic but reliable stuff. I'm gonna melt it, and hopefully I should come up with a beautiful chocolate bar.
This is so wrong on so many levels. I don't even know where to start.
To have got a soft texture, there's no sheen on this. It's melting very rapidly in my hands. And then of course there is this funny bending situation. Okay, that's... It's not super appetizing, to be honest. I'm still gonna give it a try just for science. Of course for science. It's waxy, it's gritty, sticky. Very soft to the bite.
Yeah, so not super pleasant. But to be honest, this was expected since I wanted to prove my point using this alpha or gamma crystallized form. Theory. Chocolate, I mean the great chocolate we know, is one of the crystallized form of cocoa butter. Indeed, cocoa butter is polymorph. The molecules inside, the fat molecules, also called triglyceride, can arrange in many different ways. Six, in fact.
Gamma, alpha, beta prime 2, beta prime 1, beta 2, beta 1.
Now don't worry, it's just for showing off that I'm using the... Each of those crystallized form has its own specific melting point. Different tasting characteristics as well. Like for example, the first two, they are too soft, they are too crumbly, they are almost grainy, and they have visible traces of blooming. Three and four, they are a bit better in the sense that they are a bit firmer, but they are lacking the audible snap, so particular to chocolate, and also the sheen that is so beautiful on the surface of chocolate. And that's why we favor number five, which has all those tasty characteristics, unlike beta one, which is also very firm, but melts way too slowly. So I know it all sounds very theoretical at the moment, but I've got a super practical example. In fact, you remember that time when you left, you know, that chocolate bar in the sun to melt, put it back in the fridge and everything is gonna be back to normal, life is gonna be great again, and then you tasted it and life sucked. At that moment you experience what was the taste of a crystallized form number one, two, or maybe three. That's why we need to go for form number five, which is great, but can only be made through a specific process called tempering. And that's exactly what we're gonna do right now. This. I've got a bit of a situation here since I wanted to make a double boiler I guess it's a pretty accurate representation of life.
Not exactly what you expected, but should be fine.
-50 degrees Celsius is the temperature I'm aiming at. Okay, so everything is clean. Just need to... Hold on a second. Wow! 30 degrees, 50 degrees, 70 degrees, 45, ah man, it's getting cold. So to temper chocolate, we've got a few options, but all of them have to do with time, temperature and movement. The one I'm gonna use right now is the most classic one. It's like the OG chocolate tempering technique. You're supposed to pour the hot chocolate on a marble. Marble. Marble? You know what? Spoiler alert, I don't think that marble is so important. I think like stainless steel should be just fine. And yet, this is the first time I'm tempering chocolate, so I'm scared as I feel very alone at the moment. I'm gonna put it on the table and start moving with those, you know, tools of the trade of a proper French pâtissier. A Chinese cleaver and a barbecue. You just wanna put 2/3 of that beautiful melted liquid. Okay, quick temperature check. 36. I'm trying to bring it down to 28 degrees Celsius. Okay, time to put it back in the bowl along with the initial third. I am now at 33 degrees Celsius, which is exactly what I wanted to achieve. I'm also surprised about this, to be honest. That temperature curve is responsible for bringing the cocoa butter into the perfect crystallized form. I should be pouring this into a mold. Perhaps the most precious tip of this whole adventure is to make the molds in advance. So that's basically how you're supposed to temper chocolate by tabling it. The whole table is a mess at the moment, but at least there's nothing left to do apart from leaving this to cool at room temperature, so super slow until it completely sets. So this one is fairly easy for me as I'm a big user of Audible in the first place. Now, to be honest, like the very core principle of an audiobook just fits my lifestyle pretty well. I'm always on the move, I've been traveling a lot recently, I'm always cooking or doing the groceries, and just knowing that I can put those dead times to good use is great. So the book I'm listening to at the moment is called The Obstacle is the Way by Ryan Holiday, and it's a practical introduction to stoicism and also how to turn difficulties or obstacles into opportunities. If you go to audible.com/frenchguycooking, you can get 3 months of Audible for $6.95 a month. Okay, back to chocolate. Right, so after cooling the whole thing down, this is my batch number 2, the one I made. I've definitely got a better shine, especially on the side that was exposed to aluminium. I'm now gonna give it a snap and see if I can hear something. It's better, it's not perfect, it's not bendy anymore. Mm. Oh, so definitely firmer to the bite. Not grainy, which is good. It's not bad. However, I feel like the tabling process or method just allows too much room for error. Now, of course, I'm not saying that the tabling method doesn't work. I'm just saying that it's, you know, just easy to mess up and extremely messy on top of that. Luckily for us, I mentioned there are plenty ways you could temper chocolate, and one of them is allegedly super simple, but I wanted to show you the classic first. It's called the seeding method, and it basically puts to good use a property of crystals. Crystallization tends to happen following any pattern already in place, which means that in that puddle of hot melted chocolate, if we were to introduce some stable beta crystals, then the rest of the mass would basically follow the pattern we just introduced, so they would become beta crystals as well themselves. Themselves as well. You get the point. Right, so I've got 75% of my chocolate melting at the moment, but I've kept 25% on the side. I'm gonna use them to seed this part. Okay, so to cool things down a bit more rapidly, I've switched to a bowl of just, you know, reasonably cold water. You can definitely feel that the mixture is getting thicker and thicker as we're getting closer to 32 or 31 degrees Celsius. Yeah, I'm gonna perform a test. If you did your job correctly, that should set within a few minutes. You see? It's only been like 3 or 4 minutes and it's not sticky anymore. Which means... yes! Okay. Of course, I'm definitely gonna improve this in the future, but for now, that will do. Because I had some tempered chocolate leftovers, I also spread some super thin on this parchment paper just to see if I get any result this way as well. So I think this chocolate is fully set. Firm, probably a bit thick,
smooth,
not grainy at all. I managed to get down to the crystallized form of cocoa butter molecules that I wanted. I managed to do it. Now, of course, with the success come a few challenges, otherwise it would be too simple. Not sure if you can catch them, but I've still got a few bubbles inside. The taste is not amazing. I know why. I know why. Of course I know why. I've been neglecting the commodity, the raw material I've been using so far. This is just baking chocolate. Have you ever tasted baking chocolate? It's not great. I strongly suspect my problems to be all connected. The fluidity in chocolate is related to the percentage of cocoa butter inside. And basically, the better the chocolate, the higher those percentages are. And of course, with the greater fluidity, you've got less bubbles since they can come up to the surface and just pop instead of just being trapped inside while the chocolate is setting. So I need to get my hands on better product. Luckily for us, I've been doing some groundwork and I've got something. I bought myself some premium chocolate chips. To be more specific, this is not baking chocolate, this is called... I hope you enjoy this episode, I hope you enjoy the chocolatey journey. I find it to be delightful, to be honest. If you did, then please give it a big thumbs up, like it, share it, spread it like butter everywhere. And of course, subscribe to the channel, because in the next episode, we're obviously gonna make some better chocolate. Take care, bye bye, salut.